Who are you? Has anyone ever asked you to define yourself? Say you meet someone for the first time and they ask who you are. What do you say? Are you a mom, a wife, a teacher, a nurse, a Christian, a daughter? What do you say? Who are you? More often than not, we identify ourselves as the things that we do. That's who you are. That's who you say you are. It's who I say I am. I'm a new mom. I have a 3-month-old son. And shortly after having him, a couple people said something to me that just started to not sit well with me. They said, you no longer have your own identity. You'll forever be known as Declan's mom. And at first I loved it. I wanted to be a mom for so long. And so I loved hearing that I was his mom. And I loved people seeing me as his mom. But then I started to think about it and I sat on it. And then I thought, I don't want people to only see me just as a mom. While it's great, there's so much more. For so long, I wanted to be a wife. I wanted to get married and everything would be perfect. And then I did. And I wasn't satisfied. And then I thought, I really want to be the teacher. I want to have the perfect job. I want to teach this grade. And then I did. Still wasn't satisfied. And then it became, I want to be a mom. I want to be a parent. And I am. And I'm still not satisfied. If I identify myself in the things that I do, I will never be fully satisfied. And I will always want something more. Christ did not come and die on the cross so that I would identify myself as a job title or as a role that I fill. And neither did he do that for you. Christ came so that you would be identified through him, in him. He tells us that you are a light and to shine throughout the whole earth so that people will know him. One of my favorite verses comes from Isaiah, and I love that it's in the Old Testament because it tells exactly what our identity is and who it is found in. It's Isaiah 43:1. It says, "But now, thus says the Lord, your creator, O Jacob, and he who formed you, O Israel, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine." I love that God from the very beginning sets your identity in place. You are his. You belong to him. He calls you by your name. No longer should you identify yourself with the things that you do. Identify yourself in Christ. Identify yourself as a daughter of the King. Identify yourself as loved and chosen by the living God. He calls you by name. He loves you. He wants you more than ever, in spite of all of the reasons why we think not. Cling on to that. Hold on to that truth. So, who are you?